Welcome to the Applied Hydraulics Module 1 class. Last time we covered the dimensional analysis. This time we are going to cover model analysis. In this, the syllabus is model analysis, similitude, types of similarities, force ratios, similarity law, model classification, Reynolds model, Froude's model, Euler's model, Weber's model, Mach model. We are also going to discuss about scale effects, distorted models, and numericals on Reynolds number and Froude's model. Right? So, my dear friends, we will now start our discussion. Outcome of the session is to understand application of model analysis and similitude concepts to hydraulic machinery and hydraulic structures. Okay? We need to understand the model analysis and similitude concepts to hydraulic machinery and hydraulic structures. Types of similarities, how we are going to apply to real type problems. Also, model classification and the scale effects and distorted models. So, these are our points of discussion. First, we will learn what is model analysis. As the name suggests, it's a model. I think I already explained to you a actual, which is a prototype. It can be smaller or bigger than the model. And model I would like to analyze. So, model analysis is helping us to know the performance of actual structures. For example, I want to construct a dam. You know very well dam is very big. The length may be around 200 meters. The height may be around 24 meters. Very difficult to visualize that. What exactly happens when it stores water? What actually happens when earthquake comes? What happens if there is a big flood? In that case, what I will do, I will prepare a small model, maybe to a scale of 1 is to 24 or 1 is to 10, and I will study the model in the laboratory. I will analyze how it is submerging, if I release the water, whether it is flooding downstream. What are the forces acting on the dam? What is the uplift pressure due to seepage? All those things can be modeled and predicted well before actual construction. So, my dear friends, model studies is about the performance of the actual hydraulic structures before it is being made. This applies to even turbines, pumps, and also compressors. It means I can run an actual turbine in a small shape, okay, before I construct it in BHEL Bhopal, right? So, my dear friends, model study is basically, we prepare the model to a scale, we will see its performance, maybe velocity ratios, maybe acceleration, maybe force, maybe geometrical distortion, maybe submergence, any parameter, okay? Then we will see how this information is transformed to the actual one. We say it's a scale effect. We will discuss it. Now, as if I define, it is the scale replica of the actual structure, which is called model, right? The models are not always small. It may be even bigger also, okay? What is prototype? Prototype is a actual structure. Real structure, you can say that it's a real structure. Real structure or machine. So, we are going to understand one thing very clear. I am going to study a model, force on that, what is the velocity, what is the displacement, what is the rotation, what is the cavitation. All these things I am going to study in a model. then I will see its result in the actual. So this helps me to improve the design. Suppose if the design is not good, it will not control the flood, then I will change the dam height. Suppose dam is not stable, I will add some other material and see that stability is increased. So this kind of advantages are there when I take the model study. Okay, so I will continue. Now I have shown you two diagrams. You can see a model is shown here, a canal is being shown with a gates. I am able to have a replica of say our Visveshwaraya canal in a model form, in which flow is taking place here. You can see the flow is going on and gates are studied. I can exactly see whether the distribution of water to farmers is proper or not. That's a model study. Then once I prepare the same thing in Visveshwaraya canal somewhere downstream of Kaveri dam, I can see the performance and say okay, right? Other side, you can see there is a aeroplane which is kept in a wind tunnel. I am going to, normally I think you know very well, aeroplane will be going in the air. Okay, aeroplane velocity is very high, maybe around 600 km per hour. Okay, and more or less outside air is constant, but what is the relative motion? I will keep the aeroplane model constant and allow the air to flow very fast. Opposite model, we will do it opposite. So you can see it is kept in a wind tunnel, aeroplane model. Wind is blowing with a very Mach number, I will talk about that number, and I will have a sensors here to see whether the boundary layer on this particular blades, I can see the boundary layer on the nose of this aeroplane, and also I can see on the tail of the aeroplane. Okay, this is called nose, this is called tail, and these are the wings. It means these models can be studied before they are put into action in a wind tunnel. Okay, so this is what actually we would like to do before we construct an original machine or original dam, right? So I have explained you the concept of model study with reference to the actual. We are going to study the performance of the model correlate with the actual. Is it okay? Now let's go ahead. Now you may be thinking, okay sir, you have told about the model testing, where we can apply this? You can see the list is very big. Civil engineering structures like dams, weirs, canals, spillways, we are using it in a very maximum extent. We have a Karnataka engineering research station at KRS dam, where we have all models, even Almaty dam model also is there. Okay, and we have one more institute called CWPRS Pune, Central Water Power Research Station Pune, Khadakwasla, where we have a national facility for studying the flooding, for studying the erosion of banks, for studying the all the dams and all, and machines also. Flood control is another issue which we can study with the help of this. Hydraulic machines, turbines, pumps, compressors, even windmills. Windmills also we can study now. We can add any hydraulic machine or any fluid machine to this system. Okay, design of harbors, ships and submarines, they are of very prime importance to the government of India because of its defense. We are going to study all these things before we launch those in actual. Even you can say aeroplanes, rockets, missiles, helicopters. All they are very important. Tall buildings to predict the wind load. Okay, we have now, right now we are doing a small problem. One school, government school, is trapped between tall buildings, three, four tall buildings in Bengaluru. Okay, the principal of the school has requested us, our East Point group of institution, that can you study why the wind is not coming to our kids, the fan is running, why this is happening. So we would like to see what is the effect of tall buildings on a nearby sandwiched school, why it is happening. So we are going to make a model of that. We are going to test in wind tunnel and we will give the solution for this. So I hope you understand what exactly I am saying. We can have this application to a great extent, right? Then we will see next slide. Similitude, I think this I already explained in the previous class, I will repeat. The result obtained in the model analysis represent the behavior of actual. For example, if the actual is going to be successful, say we have a Tehri dam in Himachal Pradesh. Before it is constructed, dam was constructed, then they said, no sir, it is not safe towards the earthquake. Unfortunately or fortunately, I remember Uttarkashi earthquake was there. There was a big tremor was there before the dam was constructed. So they modified it and now the dam is safe. We have a geometrical similarity, which we talked about the length similarity, length and diameter. Okay. Then we have what? Kinematic similarity. It is about the velocity, pressure. We are going to correlate the model pressure with the actual pressure. We are going to correlate model dimension to the actual dimension. And then we are going to talk about the force similarity. Force similarity, when we prepare this particular thing. So these things I already explained. It is just a repetition because we are going to now go in more deeper way. Is it okay? So far I explained to you what exactly is a model. It's a replica of a actual. We are going to test it in a laboratory. We will see its performance. We will correlate to the actual. What kind of similarities are there? Geometric, length and diameter. Then we have a kinematic, velocity and pressure. Then we have a dynamic similarity, which is the force similarity. Is it okay? So we will take next slide. Now, more deeper. Similitude, flow similarity and model studies. Models which are not geometrically similar are called geometrically distorted models. Distorted means, I told you one example, if you remember, the length of the river is say 1500 kilometer, say Kaveri, and depth is hardly say 10 meter. I cannot take the same scale. I can represent 1500 kilometer, maybe maximum up to 1.5 kilometer, or you can say 150 meter. But I cannot take the same scale on y axis. I have to reduce, because I have to see that they are all matching, so that we can take measurements. Otherwise, same scale if I take, it becomes mm. So it is not possible. So we say it is geometrically distorted models. Length of the model divided by length of the prototype. M stands for model, M for the model, and P stands for prototype or actual. Okay, so mind it well. Whenever I say M, small m, it's a model. Whenever I say P, it is a prototype. Is it okay? Now, my dear friends, one thing is very clear. I am talking about geometric similarity. Geometric means, you know very well, geometry means length. Geometry means area. And geometry means the volume. So if I take length similarity, it becomes a length ratio. We say length ratio. I repeat, it is called LR. It is width of the model divided by width of the prototype, height of the model divided by height of the prototype, diameter of the model diameter of the prototype. Okay, as I mentioned, Kaveri pipe is 1 meter. I will take only say 10 centimeter. So it will be like 1 meter means 100 centimeter, and model is 10 centimeter. So what is your LR? LR is now 1:10. Is it okay? Is it okay? I repeat, I am taking Kaveri pipeline 1 meter, which is giving water from Kaveri to Bangalore. I want to test in my laboratory. Kaveri pipeline is 1 meter diameter. So I am writing 100 centimeter. Okay, and it should be reverse actually. This should be 100. 100 centimeter prototype, and model is 10 centimeter. So model divided by prototype will take the ratio. See, it becomes 1/10. Similarly, we will take for area ratio. I can take area ratio, area of the model divided by area of prototype. Okay, we say LR square. Everybody knows area is measured in meter square. Correct? Area is measured in meter square. Length is measured meter. Area is meter square. Then what about volume? Yes, you are right. Volume is LR cube, because this is measured meter cube. So my dear friends, geometric similarity is explained to you. Geometric of length, geometry of diameter, geometry of area, and geometry ratio of volumes. Is it okay? Now we will take next one. Now we will talk about kinematic similarity. Kinematic similarity is the similarity ratio between the model divided by prototype in terms of velocity, in terms of pressure, so that we can have correlation. Now let us see. Velocity of the model is say 1 meter per second, and velocity of prototype is say 20 meter per second. What is the ratio now? It will be 1/20. Is it okay? So I will represent it by VR. We are going to represent by VR. We say velocity ratio. What is LR? Length ratio. What is area? LR square. What is volume? LR cube. Then velocity is velocity ratio. It is this one. And similarly, we can have acceleration also. Acceleration ratio also is called AR. So all these things correspond to kinematic similarity. So I can model and prototype maybe geometrical similar, maybe kinematically similar. And next one I am going to take, dynamic similar. Dynamic means basically it means the force similarity. Force similarity. What is the meaning? Meaning is simple. If there is a sphere, I am testing in model. If I am putting a force here, it is say 10 newtons. Okay? You have a very big sphere. Maybe you are tunneling for metro in Bangalore. Okay, the big sphere is normally curving inside. Then what is actually? It may be 10,000 newtons. It means I am comparing the force in the model to the force to the prototype. A big building is there. Okay, because of the wind, the force is say 55 newtons. Example. Okay, it is a model. Suppose same building, maybe 25 story. It is 55,000 newtons. Definitely, these things can be having a ratio. It is called force similarity. My dear friends, you can see it is the similarity of forces. The flow in the model and the prototype are dynamically similar. All the corresponding point. Okay. For example, if I draw, say, this is structure. This is structure. Small. Suppose it is going, the force here is say 10 kilonewton at this point, say P. Here we say P dash. here we say P dash. Here force will be 10 Newton. It means same type of body, maybe a boat, the at the nose the value is 10 kilonewton. Same point P dash here, P dash, okay, P dash here is 10 Newton. Similarly, I can compare here, say minus 25 kilonewton in the wake. This is the flow. This is say minus 0.25. Okay. You can see here the nature is same, minus force, okay, opposite. Positive is drag, negative is lift, everybody knows, right? So, my dear friends, exactly we can compare what is the force here and what is the corresponding force. Maybe this is say Q, this is Q dash. All these things you can imagine for a dam, all these things you can imagine for a spillway, all this thing you can imagine for a any hydraulic machine, turbines, compressors, pumps, everywhere this is applicable. So, I have explained to you that force of I stands for inertia. You can see inertia force is coming into picture, viscous force is coming into picture, surface tension is also there and elastic force also there. I can have many forces. For example, inertia is the mass. If my weight is more, you can say, if I assume I am 100 kg, my inertia is big. A small kid is there, its inertia is small, it may be around 5 kg or 10 kg, okay, that is inertia. Then comes here viscous force. It is flowing in a, assume that it is flowing within a honey or a, you can say water, the water will have more resistance, okay. If you drive your vehicle on a dry road, it may give better average. If you drive your vehicle on a wet road, it will give less average. Why? Because the resistance is more in the wet condition compared to dry. Okay? So, now we have one more force called surface tension force. It is basically a line force. Then you will be thinking, what is this force, sir? We have not seen. Have you seen birds are walking on the water? Have you seen? Birds are walking on the water because of the surface tension, because of the cap. Very small force is available at the interface. That tension will allow birds to walk on that. Okay? So, this is a line force, then we have an elastic force. So, this dynamic similarity can be done with these kind of forces very nicely. Is it okay? I think so far I have explained to you what is a model analysis, how it is important, what are the applications. Then we talked about the geometric similarity, we talked about the kinematic similarity, then we discussed about the force similarity. Okay? We are talking between the model and a prototype. What is a model? A small replica or a big replica of the actual thing. It can be a turbine or it could be a aeroplane, it could be a notch, it could be a spillway. Is it okay? Now we will go to the next one. Now, you can see here kinematic and dynamic similarity illustrated in a building. Now, you may be thinking, sir is telling what? You think now, it is a big building. You can see the velocity is say 100 centimeter per second. This model could be 1 centimeter per second. Correct? I can measure the force at this point, say this point. Say 20 kilo Newton. Same point here will be 2 kilo Newton. I am giving an example. I can calculate this force here, say 50 kN. Corresponding this will be 5 kN. Some concept is there between the two. The model performance is correlated with the scaled performance. This is scale ratio is 1 is to 10. You can see it is 10 times. 5 becomes 50, 2 becomes 20. Correct? No? So, this is what we are going to study. If I have the data for the models, I can correlate for the actual. that will give me whether my design is correct, whether structure is safe, whether it can save the flood, whether the turbines can run with maximum efficiency, whether the pumps can lift the water to seventh floor. This kind of concepts are involved in this. Is it okay? Now you can see I explained here model height is 8 meter, correspondingly this will be reduced and we can calculate the wind force on a model. Is it okay? So I am able to tell you now exactly how the kinematic similarity and force similarity are in one particular building. I repeat, we are now illustrating with a building example. Kinematic similarity is velocity. Okay, you can say kinematic comes to velocity, and dynamic comes to force. Okay, so we are able to illustrate the similarity of forces at two locations, similar locations, and similarity of velocity at similar locations. So model and prototype, they are very important. We are discussing model studies, which is helping us to understand the real behavior of structures. It could be hydraulic structures or it could be machine structures. Is it okay? Now I'll take next slide. My dear friends, one more term I call similitude. Flow similarity and model studies, they are correlated. They are correlated. Incomplete similarity is a one more term. I repeat, there's a term called, sorry, I should take red. Incomplete similarity is a another term. Sometimes, I'm not saying all the times, maybe in aerodynamics, complete similarity cannot be obtained. Then you may be thinking, sir, what you are talking? We talked about three similarity, you know, my dear friends. One is geometric, one is kinematic, and last is dynamic. He says that in aerodynamics, if I make a table, if I make a table for say aeroplanes, it says that I can have a geometric similarity, no problem. I can have a kinematic similarity also, no problem. Sometimes it's quite possible you may not be having dynamic similarity. Is it clear? Three types are possible: geometric, kinematic, and dynamic. So sometimes similarity will not be complete. We have A, B, C, no? So C is not followed. Okay? If I take a river model, okay? If I take a river model, just a minute. Okay. Suppose if I take a river model, okay, if I take a river model, sorry, if I take a river model, I would like to see what is happening to this similarities. One is geometric, one is kinematic, and last is the dynamic. Okay, now I want to see what is happening for a river model. For a river model, river model, as I mentioned, x axis is very high, it is in kilometers, depth is small. So I have to take x axis different, y axis different. I cannot take same. It means it is not following geometric similarity. It may follow kinematic may follow dynamic, right? Or it may not follow anyone. This is called incomplete similarity. Is it okay? I think I explained to you what is the meaning of that. It is called incomplete similarity. So there are some cases like in aeroplanes or even river. Okay, sometimes in dams also we may not be having geometric similarity or one similarity, maybe the first similarity. We need to be very careful when we translate or we convert the model forces to the actual forces. Is it okay? So I am able to explain to you what exactly the types of similarity. We have a complete similarity, number one. Geometric is okay, kinematic is also, dynamic is also okay. But incomplete similarity is a similarity in which one is missing, okay, or one or more are missing. Is it okay? So hopefully the concept is clear, right? Now we will now see a very important term called types of models. Now so far I have discussed you about the model studies, about the similarity types, how they are followed, when they are not followed, right? Now we are coming to a point called types of model. What kind of model we have? One model is called undistorted model. What is the meaning? Undistorted model. An undistorted model is one which is geometrically similar. It means we have G, we have kinematic K, we have dynamic D, okay, GKD. So undistorted model, he is saying that which is geometrically similar. It means it is following geometrically, no problem at all. Geometrically it is okay. Okay, I repeat, what is an undistorted model? An undistorted model is one which is geometrically similar to the prototype. The conditions of similitude are completely satisfied. It means we have, this is also okay, this is also okay. What is that K? K is called kinematic similarity or velocity, acceleration, etc. What is dynamic similarity? It is the force similarity. Is it okay? So undistorted models are really good. Undistorted models are really good. We are not distorting anything. It is a complete similarity. What is G? Geometric. What is K? Kinematic. And what is D? So for number one, you can say this is okay. Is it okay? My point is clear to all? Yes or no? Okay. Now we will say distorted models. The name itself is telling the story. We need not break our head. It is saying distorted model. What is the meaning? The model is distorted. How? We will see. Distorted models. A distorted model is in which is not geometrically similar to its prototype. It means number two, if you take, put the bracket, now same geometric similarity G, kinematic K, dynamic D. If you calculate, maybe the geometric is not satisfied. This is not followed, okay, and which is called the geometric model distortion can be even lengthwise also and sometimes even material wise also. So these two may be okay. So mind it well, this type of models are there. In any question which is asking you about the types of model, you should write undistorted models and the next one is distorted models. Is it okay? So hopefully I explained to you types of model. Types of model is the one is the distorted model and other is the undistorted model. Which one you prefer? If I ask you, no doubt it is the undistorted model, because the relationship between the model and the prototype will be very, very easy. In the case of undistorted model, we can correlate. We can say the force here is say 5 Newton, in the model, it may be you can say 0.5 Newton. Some relationship can be established very easily. Okay, got it? For the distorted models, we have problems. Okay, anyway, we will see that in the scale effect later. So, hopefully, you understood till now the model studies, the similarities, then types of similarities, then we discussed about types of model. Is it okay? Shall I go next slide now? Is it okay? Okay. Now, again I am coming back where we left in the first slot, dimensionless numbers. What are these dimensionless numbers? You remember, there are primary variables M, L, T. M stands for mass, L stands for length, and T stands for time. What is the meaning? They are dimensionless. It means this is a M to power 0, L to power 0, and T to power 0. Okay? These things we discussed earlier, we have derived based on the Rayleigh method or Buckingham Pi method, the dimensionless number. You remember we derived a Reynolds number is equal to rho Vd by mu. That is the one number, Froude number, V by square root Gd. So, the dimension numbers are very important in dimensional analysis, particularly for model studies. If I am doing developing a new car, you assume that I am developing a new car. I am testing it in wind tunnel, small experiment. I want to see fire safety, for example. Okay? In that case, I need to derive some new dimensions for the fire numbers, whether it can sustain the fire. Suppose if I want to derive, or you can say devise, a new car which can take care of flood. If the flood is there, it converts to boat. Whether that kind of thing is possible, so what kind of material I should use, what kind of shape it should have, what should be the dimension x direction, what should be the y direction, all those things are correlated. So, we are going to have independent dimensions, we have to see. It is a number which can be compared between prototype, which is actual, with the model for its hydraulic performance, number one. Very useful for researchers. Significance of motion, we are using in notches. I hope you remember notches. It's a rectangular notch. It's a metal piece where water is there. Okay? It's a rectangular notch. Like that, you have V notch. Other notches are also there, trapezoidal notch and all. So, we can use it. In spillways, we can use. You know spillway? It's a spillway made of concrete where the water is released from the dam. I don't know whether you have seen, please see, videos are available, where we can see that water is gushing out. It means that these things are practically applicable. Normally people ask, no, sir, where it is applicable? You can see they are applicable in the common, in the river, in the canal, in the turbines, in the pumps, in the compressors, dam making, car making, aeroplane, missiles, submarines, rockets, anything you take, it is going to be applicable. So, these dimensionless numbers are very, very useful for notches, then weirs, we have spillways, we have orifice, mouthpiece, turbo machines, underwater flow, pipe flow, anywhere, pipe networking, anything we can do, we can use these concepts very nicely for this one. Is it okay? So, this dimensionless number which is having m to power 0, l to power 0 and t to power 0. What is that? M stands for mass, l stands for length and t stands for time. Is it okay? So, shall I go next slide now? Now, we will talk about this dimensionless number once again. This time we will cover more points. These two things we have already discussed. The first one is the Reynolds number. Normally, this is very important in pipe flow. This is the ratio of inertia to the viscous force. Inertia to the viscous force, rho Vd by mu. Rho stands for density, mass density. V is the velocity d is the diameter and mu is the dynamic viscosity. I can take the ratio between the model. You can see same thing which we applied, this can be put for model, and this can be put for actual. So, my dear friends, mind it well, whatever number we are talking, it is the ratio of two forces. Number one, in this case, it is inertia force by viscous force. Renault was the person who designed this one. Normally, this value will vary between say 0 to 10 to power 8, 9, anywhere. 0 to 2000 is laminar, 2000 to 4000 is transition, and more than 4000 is a turbulent for pipe flows. For open channel, it becomes 1/4. What is the meaning? 0 to 1000, 0 to 1000 or 500 is laminar, 500 to 1000 we can say it is a transition, beyond 1000 is basically turbulent. So, similarly we have Froude's number, normally we use for open channel, we use it for open channels. My dear friends, Froude number is the ratio of inertia to the gravity force. If the formula is velocity divided by square root L by G, normally this G cancels, you can say this is Vm V model divided by square root of length of the model is equal to Vp divided by square root of Lp. So, M stands for model, P stands for prototype. So, in the next class we will see again that different other thing other than the Renault model and the Froude's model, which are the models we are going to discuss. Okay? Thank you.